हॅलो एव्हरीवन, मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर राजश्री जावळे, असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर धनंजयराव गाडगीळ कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स, सातारा. डियर स्टुडंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट फायनान्शियल मॅनेजमेंट. यू नो दॅट मॅनेजमेंट इज युनिव्हर्सल इन नेचर. इन द मॉडर्न इंडस्ट्रियल इरा ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, देर इज नो सबस्टिट्यूट फॉर गुड मॅनेजमेंट. इट मेक्स ह्युमन एफर्ट्स मोर प्रोडक्टिव्ह अँड ब्रिंग्स बेटर टेक्नॉलॉजी products and services to our society. It also helps for many activity. It is a crucial economic resource and a life-giving element in business. Without proper management, the resources of production cannot be converted into production. Thus, management is a very important function concerned with all aspects of the working of an organization. So here we can say that management is a must to accomplish desired goal through group action. It is essential to convert the disorganized resources of a main machines, materials and methods into a useful and effective enterprise. Therefore, management is the function of getting things done through people and directing the efforts of individuals towards a common objective. In this way, we need to understand the importance of and the nature of management. According to William Springer, management is that function of an enterprise which concerns itself with the directions and control of the various activities to attain the business objectives. Management is essentially an executive function. It deals with particularly the active directions of the human efforts. So here it is very essential to understand the nature and the function of management. Now we'll talk about the meaning of management. Management is relatively a new discipline. Being a new discipline, it has drawn concepts and principles from economics, sociology, philosophy, psychology, statistics, and etc. The result is that each group has defined management differently. For example, economists see management as a factor of production. Sociologists see it as a class or group of persons. Practitioners of management treat it as a process. In spite of no clear unanimity, it is not difficult to identify the following meanings of the term management. So here in introduction, I would like to tell you that companies do not work in a vacuum, isolated from everything else. It interacts and transacts with the other entities presence in the economic environment. So here these entities include government, suppliers, lenders, banks, customers, shareholders, etc., who deals with the organizations in several ways. So here it is very important to know about the financial management. Most of these dealing results in either money flowing or flowing out from the company. This flow of money or funds has to be managed so carefully. It will result in maximum gains to the company. So here we need to understand the management in a proper manner. So here management is an art or technique of getting things done. Then what is management? Management is a process of planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. Third is management is a distinct activity of any organization. Next, management is a discipline which represent a body of knowledge. Management denotes a group of people. So here we need to understand all these nature of management or the concept of management. So here we can say that management is an art of getting things done through and with people. So this is very important. Management is the art of getting things done through and with people in formally organized group. It is the art of creating the environment in which people can perform as individuals and yet cooperate towards attainment of group's goal. It is the art of removing blocks to such performance, a way of optimizing efficiency in reaching goals. So here, if we see the corporate financial objectives, it could be to provide the link between the business and the other entities in their environment and investment and financial decision making. So if we are dealing and discussing with this, we need to understand that even management is a process. So management as a distinct process consisting of planning, organizing, actuating and controlling, perform to determine and accomplish stated objectives with the use of human being and other resources. So here management is called a process which involves planning and organizing, directing and controlling the efforts of human resources in the use of material resources. So here the definitions, George Terry, his definition is about the management. Management is a distinct activity. Management as a discipline. So here we can say, if we talk about disciplines, there are a number of disciplines which serve humankind. They are art, science, commerce, law, medicine, engineering, etc. So as a discipline, management refers to the body of knowledge and a separate field of study. So financial management is that managerial activity which is concerned with the planning and controlling of the firm's financial resources. So here definition of planning, sorry, management is there here, but we need to understand that this is a financial management. So in other words, it is concerned with acquiring, financing and managing assets to accomplish the overall goal of business enterprise. Financial management is concerned with the efficient use of an important economic resource, which is treated as capital funds. Financial management is the operational activity of a business that is responsible for obtaining and effectively utilizing the funds necessary for efficient business operations. So here what we say, that investment decisions are to be taken properly, financial decisions. Then how much capital should be raised to fund the firm's operations, that also need to be discussed properly. What is the best mix of financing these assets? So financing could be through two ways, debt and equity. So here if we talk about debt, so that may be loan from various sources like bank, financial institutions and public. If we talk about equity, so capital put in by the investor, who are also known as owners, shareholders. So these shareholders are owners because the shares represent the ownership in the company. So here if we talk about investment decisions, the investment decisions refer to as the capital budgeting decision. It simply means the decisions to acquire assets or to invest in a project. So assets are defined as economic resources that are expected to generate future benefits. Second decision is financial decision. The second financing decision or financial decision is the financial decision, which basically addresses two questions. One, how much capital should be raised to fund the firm's operations? And second, what is the best mix of financing these assets? So here in financial management, it is concerned with the managerial decisions that results in the acquisitions and financing of long-term and short-term credits of the firm. It deals with the situation that requires selection of specific assets, the selection of specific liability, as well as the problem of size and growth of an enterprise. The analysis of these decisions is based on the expected inflows and overflow of funds and their effects upon managerial objectives. So if you talk about funds, funds are raised from financial markets. Financial market is a generic term used to denote markets where financial securities are traded. These markets include money markets, debt markets and capital market. So financing and investing decisions are closely related because the company is gaining to raise money to invest in a project or assets. Those who are going to give money to the company need to understand where the company is investing their money and what it hopes to earn from the investments, so that they can assure themselves of the safety of their money. So here we will stop and we will continue from the finance in the next lecture. So I hope that you have understood the nature and the function of financial management. Thank you one and all.